Hello everyone! This time an acrylic pour painting, and for this pour painting I'm going to use the swipe technique over black acrylic paint to I'm going to try to create some nice lacing and cells. So for the new people to my channel and like experiments, tutorials of acrylic, resin and a lot of other things, consider to subscribe, click the notification bell and select all, because that way you don't miss anything. So what I already mentioned, I'm going to make an acrylic painting by using the swipe technique over a black base. And I'm using an Arteza canvas of 28 by 35 centimeters. I'm going to use different mixtures for the paints. The black base is the mixture that I also use with the flower dips that I have been done lately. But the swipe color, in this case white, is another mixture. It's a mixture of Floetrol and titanium white. So I want to see how these mixtures react to each other. So no silicon in these mixtures, only paint and mediums. So I already started with the black base, and I used the Liquitex Mars Black for this, and I'm spreading it with my palette knife. Yeah, and I've done swipe techniques before, but it was a long time ago, and I want to try it again. And I saw some really nice swipe paintings that they swipe from the middle to the side, so that's what I'm going to try. And I'm going to use some nice colors. I'm going to use an ultramarine, that is this color, and also some phthalo blue and permanent magenta. But I'm also going to use the phthalo pearl medium, because I want to see how that also will react in swiping. So this is the pearl blue, and I know I don't have to use a lot of this color, because if I use a lot of the pearl medium, then it will overtake the painting, and I don't want that. So the mixtures of the paints, I'm using an acrylic binder and a primer, just as Fiona Art does. And I'm using 80% acrylic binder and 20% of the primer, and that's my pouring medium for the paints. To mix the paints, I'm using one part paint and four parts pouring medium. And for the swipe color, in this case white, I'm using Floetrol, four parts Floetrol and one part titanium white. There you can see it, the swipe color on top of the other colors. So the mixture you can also find in the description box. And for the people that live outside of Europe, I will add comparable supplies for the acrylic binder and the primer. And I'm swiping with some Yupo paper, because I can clean Yupo paper and reuse it again. And already I'm getting some really nice lacing effects. It's an explosion, so that's okay. So those two mixtures react very well to each other. And I'm going to mention it again, no silicon in the mixtures. Yeah, I turn my canvas around, because it's much easier to swipe towards yourself. And also at the end of this video, two close-ups, one right after pouring and also a close-up after 24 hours of drying, because then we can see if the painting changed or not, because I really would like that it stays the way it is. So those two mixtures react really well to each other. I have a lot of lacing and I'm liking it a lot. It's great, and I already have some ideas that I could do this on a much larger canvas. Really nice. So again, the mixture of the pouring medium is 80% acrylic binder and 20% primer. I will put the links for comparable supplies in the description box for people that live outside of Europe. And to mix the paints, I use one part paint and four parts pouring medium. To mix the pearl blue, I mix one part pouring medium. Two parts pouring medium, one part paint, and one part Vallejo pearl medium. And already the pearl blue is rising to the top. You can see it in the middle. I'm liking this a lot. This is a great experiment. Working on the sides, I'm making them black with my brush. Also, all the supplies I'm using in this video you can find at the end of the video, but also in the description box with the links to the websites, what I always do. So also a link to Jackson's Art Supplies. It's a UK based company, and if you buy through my links, then I earn a little bit of money out of that. And if you are a new customer, then with your first order you get 10% discount, so that's great. And also there you can find the Vallejo pearl medium, but I also list them in my Influencers Amazon store, also the Vallejo pearl medium and all the paint colors I've used. And in my Influencers Amazon store I have linked all the materials I prefer to use in my art. Yeah, and I have a lot of lacing. At the end of this video, what I already mentioned, you will see a close-up and then you can see the lacing much better. It's really nice. And I hope it stays the way it is. And those colors go very well together. And I also want to add something extra in the middle part where the white is of this painting. It needs something extra. You will see that in a minute. You can see it. I want to add some cold dots in the middle, and I'm using the Testor's enamel gold paint, and with my stirring stick I make small dots and larger dots only on the white parts of the painting. I think that will look nice. There you can see it. I'm dripping the color onto the white. And this enamel paint you can also use in resin, but I also wanted to try it on top of acrylic paint and see what it does. Yes, and I also want to give you an update on the plaster coasters and pendants I'm working on. It's very rainy here in the Netherlands, so that's why I didn't pour. Because, yeah, if the humidity is very high, it can affect your resin. So today it's a better day, so I will pour some resin today in the molds, and I hope I can upload the video of the end result of the pendants and the coasters tomorrow. So I'm so sorry that I didn't show you the video, an update of those coasters and pendants yet. But yeah, hopefully I can show you all tomorrow. And then we will know if it works, plaster and resin together. I'm very excited for that. Yeah, and I hope so that the lacing will stay the way it is, because it looks great. It's an explosion of cells and lacing effects. So those two mixtures of the acrylic binder and primer together, but also the swipe color, in this case white, with the Floetrol, yeah, works very well. So no silicone. So that saves me for cleaning the painting when it's dry. So one time with the torch for the air bubbles, and then I will show you a close-up right after pouring, so that you can see the lacing much better, but also the gold Dutch I added in the middle. So this is a close-up right after pouring, and I want to show you the lacing up close, but also the gold dots. They shimmer very much. It's a really nice gold enamel paint. There you can see it, an explosion of cells and lacing. Really nice. But also the pearl blue, there you can see it already. Is looking great in this painting. It shimmers very much, the pearl medium, phthalo pearl medium. Now a little bit closer, there you can see it. It's so beautiful. There are the gold dots I've added. There you can see the pearl blue. So the phthalo pearl medium also reacts very well with the other mediums. So this experiment was a success in my eyes. So, but yeah, I need to wait for 24 hours to see if the lacing stays. But now it looks very nice. Also some multicolored cells. So that's also nice. Yeah, I wasn't expecting this much lacing. So this is how the painting looks after 24 hours of drying, and I'm so happy because the painting stayed the way it was right after pouring. So the lacing is still there and it didn't change. So yeah, I'm really happy with this painting and with this experiment of different mediums together. And I also really like the gold dots I've added. So it's not totally dry yet. The middle part is still wet, but it's already drying on the outside. And what I also need to mention, if you use the acrylic binder and the primer, it dries really shiny. So that's great. But the lacing is so beautiful. There you have a closer look, some multicolored cells, what I already mentioned. I also like the enamel paint I've used. And there you can see the pearl blue cells. So this is a great experiment. So if you like what I'm doing, please subscribe to my channel. Give me a thumbs up because that's very important for my channel. All the information about where I buy my materials you can find at the end of the video, but also in the description box. I also added the links to the websites, but you can also find my Instagram page and my Facebook page. So there's a lot of information in the description box. And if you are curious, please check it out. And also the mixture of the paints is in the description box. And the comparable supplies for the acrylic binder and the primer for people that live outside of Europe. I want to thank you all so much for watching again. And I will see you in the next video. Bye!